Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the React Toolbar component from Syncfusion. In general, a toolbar displays a collection of clickable icons, buttons, or some other element that perform specific functions when you click on them. In this video, I am going to show you how to add a React Toolbar component to a React app, and then I will explain how to set prefix icons and separators, add input-based components to the toolbar, and change the toolbar display mode. Now, I am going to create my project with the help of the Create React App toolchain, which installs the latest version of React, and React DOM, and React scripts. I will view and edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and view the output on one of the supported browsers. To create a new React project, I need to install Create React App globally on my machine, using the command npm install -g create react app. As I have already installed it, I am skipping that step here. Now, let me create a new React project using the command create react app project name. I want to create a React app with TypeScript, so let me add --template TypeScript to the existing command. And I name my project toolbar component. This will create an empty React application with no Syncfusion packages. I will navigate to the newly created application folder to start using the toolbar component within this empty application. I install the Syncfusion React toolbar package and its subcomponent packages using the command npm install --ej2react-navigations --save. Once the installation is complete, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is open the app.tsx file and import the toolbar component from the ej2react-navigations package. Next, I will replace the default code and add the React toolbar component within the render method of the React component. Next, I open the index.tsx file and import register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the Syncfusion React trial license key by using the register license method. The Syncfusion React license key registration is required from the 2022 Volume 1 release onward. Next, I define the CSS for the toolbar. I can either import the React toolbar component CSS in the app.css file or reference the CDN link in the index.html file. To make it simple, I choose the second option. So, let me open the index.html file and reference the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. In this toolbar, I am planning to show these six items. So, first, I need to import items directive and item directive from Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations to add the items in the toolbar. Then, I will define the items directive tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of item directive definitions inside it. Let me define six item directive tags within this items directive tag. For these, I need to set the display name, so I will define the property text and set appropriate string values to it. Next, I am going to run this example using the command npm start. Here you can see the toolbar component rendered with the six commands cut, copy, paste, bold, italic, and underline. I want to pair relevant icons with the toolbar options, so to add those icons, I need to define the prefix icon property of the toolbar. I define the property prefix icon and set appropriate class names to it. Within this index.css file, I will define a font face with a specific source path and name its font family toolbar icons to start accessing the required font icons for this toolbar at the application level. Then, to these class names, I set the defined font family. To access the needed font icons, I assign the appropriate content values to those class names that are assigned to the prefix icon properties. You can see the content values for these icons at the documentation link I have shared in the description for this video. Looking at the output, you can see the toolbar items are now displayed with prefix icons. If I want to set the icons after the text, I need to set the property suffix icon with appropriate class names. Now, you can see the icons for the toolbar items are shown after the text. While we are at it, notice that the toolbar items are displayed continuously. If I want to group and separate those options, then I need to use the separator property. I am planning to display the separator after the first three options, so to do that, I will define another item directive tag within this item's directive tag. Then, I need to define the property type and set its option as separator. When you look at the toolbar now, the separator is shown after three options. I will move on to the toolbar display mode. When I add a huge number of options or commands in the toolbar, the toolbar's default content space may exceed the viewing area. To handle this scenario, I need to specify the appropriate toolbar display mode. There are four display modes available in the React toolbar: scrollable mode, pop-up mode, multi-row mode, and extended mode. By default, the toolbar displays its overflowing items in scrollable mode. To show you how the default scrollable mode works, first, I will define the width property. Then, I will add 10 more items to the toolbar, along with separators. Next, I define the icon content for these new toolbar items within this index.css file. When you look at the output page now, the toolbar items are displayed in a single line, with horizontal scrolling enabled at both ends to move back and forth between the items. If I want to display those overflowing items in a pop-up, then I need to define the property overflow mode and set its value as pop-up. You can see, when I click the down arrow in the toolbar, the pop-up displays the overflowing items. Suppose I want to display those same overflowing toolbar items in multiple rows, then I need to set the overflow mode as multi-row. Now, you can see the toolbar items displayed in multiple rows. Next, I will show you how the toolbar items are displayed in extended overflow mode. I will set the overflow mode as extended. And now, you can see, when I click the down arrow, the other toolbar options are shown in an extended row like this. Finally, I will show you how to add input components to the toolbar. For the sake of clarity, I am going to keep four of the toolbar items and remove all others. I am planning to add numeric text box and drop-down list input components to the toolbar. So, let me define two item directive tags inside the item's directive tag. I define the property type and set its item type as input to add input components to the toolbar. To use the React drop-down list component here, I need to install the Syncfusion EJ2 React drop-downs package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2-react-dropdowns --save. I have already installed this package, so I am skipping this step. Then, I import the dropdown list and numeric text box namespaces to start working with the numeric text box and dropdown list components. Next, I need to use the template property here to pass the input-based components. Within these item directive tags, let me define the template property first. Then, I will define two variables named template dropdown list and template numeric text box to include the input components. For the numeric text box, I will define width, value, and format properties with appropriate values. Next, I am going to bind data for the dropdown list, so let me define the data source property and assign the string values to it. Then, I will define width and index properties to set a custom width and to show the second index item in the data source as the selected value in the dropdown. Now, I assign this template numeric text box and template dropdown list variables to the template property. Now everything is set, and you can see the toolbar with the numeric text box and dropdown list input components. Let's recap what we have done in this video. We saw how to create a React app and added the Syncfusion React Toolbar component to it. We saw how to set prefix icons, separators, and display modes for the toolbar component, and how to add input-based components like numeric text box and drop-down list to it. If you would like to see a working example you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.